a very exciting moment for a lot of the patients here at Sutter, out in Roseville, brand new infusion center. Come down if you didn't see it before. 42 brand new rooms, double the size that they were before. And now we talked about a lot of patients come here with cancer, but that's not it. It covers a lot of different conditions. We are here, actually, we're gonna come in and chat with Michelle. Michelle, thank you so much. We chatted in the lobby area as you're coming and checking in. And I was just telling people, not everybody here that comes in has cancer. You actually have a different condition, right?
Yes, it's called hypogammaglobulin anemia, a very long word for that the bacterial side of my immune system doesn't work. So I come in here and I basically have them fill up my gas tank and I burn it off and run on it for a week and I come back.
We have to ask you, we were chatting before, I didn't want to give it away. This is your first time in this new space.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about the anticipation and how you feel so far.
I have been so excited for, well, years, but the last couple of months when it was just getting so close, I have been waiting. And I got the phone call last week that we were coming here, and I started screaming and jumping up at the down when they called me.
Did anybody think it was crazy you're excited about your new treatment center?
They were looking at me funny, going, what? And I said, the new building, we're going to the new building. They were like, oh, okay. I went, you don't understand. It's exciting for me, and it's exciting for the nurses, because this is something built for them specifically.
Can you talk a little bit about that, the importance of having a space that's built for what you need? I was mentioning, and we talked about before, for example, this space, the room, the private, semi-private rooms, twice as big as the old ones.
Yes, they are. And all the other places that I've been here on the Sutter property have been sort of retrofitted to fit their needs. This is the first place that's been built specifically for infusions. So I know it's going to make it easier on the nurses. It's going to make their jobs a lot less complicated. And they'll be able to use their time better, because this is something that was built for them and for the needs of infusions, which are different than some of the other areas of the hospital. So
you kind of referenced it there, but you talked a little bit about how long you've been doing this treatment. It's 25 years, 15 years.
Yes.
Can you tell me, I just love your mental, where you're at with how you feel about these treatments and how you think you've gotten this far.
Well, people ask me, when I was diagnosed with this in my early 30s, they said I might live till I was 44 if I was lucky. I'm very happy to say that I recently turned 59 and I'm very proud. And people ask me, why do I think that I've lasted so long? And I said, well, I do think that I haven't gotten quite holy enough for God yet, and the devil's afraid of me, so they both decided to leave me be, and that's fine with me.
I love it. Thank you so much, Michelle, for sharing your story. One of many very excited patients here. Now it's all opening piece by piece. We can't wait to see what it looks like once everything opens, but so far, everybody's quite happy. We'll send it back to you guys.
Yeah, and good for her. She's got the right mentality, totally has the right frame of mind.